long way out at sea, and it seemed like it might be a long time before we saw him again. And he could fly just like birds on the wind, and his hair was the coolest hair. And every day was 4 or 5 days and days and days and days and days and days. And the hours fell like the rocks they used to build the pyramids. Milo is your best friend, he's your second cousin, all from sleep to his rising sun. Milo is a long, long way from home, yeah. Milo is a name you won't forget, Milo I haven't met yet. In a cave below the ground, way down, it's cold and it's dark, but it knows his way around, and the mazes of the underground are no match for him. But it looks just like a traveler who hasn't showered in a while, been living in the ground. Milo's your best friend, he's your second cousin, all from sleep to his rising sun. Milo is a long, long way from home, yeah. Milo is a name you won't forget, Milo I haven't met yet. That was my guitar solo.
Yeah.
That's alright. It's not a very good one, but it took me about a year to learn that. I wrote this song for my wife when she was pregnant with our daughter. And we thought we were gonna have a little boy, because people kept saying, "You're gonna have a little boy." And we were trying to pick out names for a little boy. And my wife really liked the name Milo. Is there anybody here named Milo? Good, I don't like that name. And my wife and I, we got in kind of an argument about it, because we had a name all picked out for a little girl, and there was a story attached. And when I asked her, "Why do you want to name a little boy Milo?" she said, "Because it sounds pretty." And I said, "No, you can't do that. You can't name a kid something because it sounds pretty. There has to be a story to go along with it, like it's got to be your grandfather's name, or your favorite baseball player, or a hitchhiker that you picked up once, or something, but it doesn't matter. There just has to be a story, so that when the kid gets older and says, 'Why did you name me that?' you can say, 'Well, this one time we picked up this hitchhiker, and he was totally awesome. He changed our lives. And he stole our car and left us tied up in a ditch, but it was awesome.' And then the kid's got a story, a path, something to hold on to. But if a kid gets older and asks, 'Why did you name me this?' and you say, 'Because it sounds pretty,' I believe that that will screw a kid up. That's just what I believe. So my wife and I got in a fight about it. And I learned the hard way that you should never, ever, under any circumstances, fight with a pregnant woman. And I wrote this song for my wife. It's called Milo. And it kind of worked on two levels, because a few years later we had a little boy. And I asked my wife, "So, we're going to have a little boy now. Do you want to name him Milo?" And she said, "I'm not naming a kid after one of your songs." So it was like an apology, and I win. He's a beggar than life superhero. He's a captain of the ping pong team. He's a quantum physicist. He's a molecular biologist. He's not in it for the ladies. He's a nice guy, and he speaks well, and I would do well to be more